Hello and welcome to appmedic.firstaid. My name is AppMark. In this video, we are going to familiarize ourselves with the first aid box and its contents. We're going to be looking at each and every item, one after the other. We have opened the box and we are looking at the contents from the inside. This is the way they are packed. So now we are going to be getting one item after the other. This is a triangular bandage. It is in a triangular form. These come in a quantity of 18. Now, this triangular bandage, these are used to cover dressings on wounds. It is to make a sling to support the arm which has been injured, to fix splints in case of fracture, to form a tourniquet to stop bleeding. Then the last point is to apply pressure over a dressing to stop bleeding. We may also say or call it pressure bandage. These interlockable splints, they are called interlockable because, as you can see, there are pieces. This is a piece, this is a piece, and this other one is also a piece. So now they have been joined here. So you are able to join them. It's locked too. So you can lock them by fixing them like this. Now they are called interlockable in the sense that you are able to join them to the desired length. For example, let me get the other pair. So this and this, these have been locked. So I can lock, get the female part and the male part, lock them together. Like that. So if this is the length that I require to use, then I can go ahead and start using this splint the way it is. Or if it is too short, I can get another piece and join it to it. So these are used to immobilize fractures on limbs. Item number 3 is surgical gloves. So this is a pair of gloves. You can put them like that. As a first aider, you must protect yourself from direct contact with blood and open body fluids. So it's very important for you to cover yourself, protect your hands, protect yourself in this way. The large dressings, these come in the quantity of 4. This is a large dressing. So these are mostly applied on large wounds. The medium dressings, these are medium dressings. They come in a quantity of 8. So this is the way the medium dressing looks like. Finger dressing. The finger dressings come in a quantity of 12. These are smaller enough to be applied on a finger. It's a pair of scissors. Scissors is used to have access to the wound by cutting a piece of clothes of the injured to expose and examine it before treatment. So we used to cut a piece of cloth like that so that we can expose wound and examine it so that we can do the treatment thereafter. Item number 8 from our first aid box. These are twisting sticks. These are used mostly to make alternative bandage tourniquet in place of a rubber tourniquet when we do not have enough of them. They are used together with these bandages. This triangular bandage, we have a way of making this tourniquet. The rubber tourniquet, which I've just been talking about. So we have 2 of them. These are the 2 rubber tourniquets that we have. So this is how they look like, these 2 rubber tourniquets. We have this part here. This part we use to fasten. So we need to test it, test its elasticity away from the patient. There is so much to be said about the tourniquet, its precautions, advantages and disadvantages. We shall do in another video where we shall talk more about the rubber tourniquet and the bandage tourniquet. Number 10 item is the cotton wool. It's the total amount of 400 grams. This is the soft white stuff that is applied on top of the dressing to absorb the blood that will likely be coming out as we transport our patients to the hospital. So this is how it looks like. You can see it's so soft. So we apply this one on top of a dressing. After we dress the wound, we put this thing on top of the dressing so that whatever blood that will still be coming out will be absorbed by this cotton wool. These are splint paddings. They are used as cushion when splints are applied in case of fracture. More padding should be applied where the bone is fractured and where the bones are more prominent, like the knees and ankles, to reduce the pain of friction. They come in a quantity of 500, so you may need more of these things. Now this is the white lint. They come in a quantity of 4. There are 4 of them. So this white lint is a special material. It is used on wounds caused by burns. If our skin is exposed to heat or burns, open flame or fluids, anything that causes our skin to be burned. So to cover those, such kind of wounds, we use this white lint. We also use it on peppered wounds. A patient who has been exposed to an environment where there were explosives or there was a bomb, and those peppered wounds are caused by flying objects, the stones which come, many of them, and then they make wounds either on the face. So we use white lint to cover the face. We also use these white lint to cover the protruding bowels of the on the abdomen. These are crepe bandages. They come in a quantity of 4. As you can see, there are 4 of them. It is a crepe bandage. So these are just the pins to hold them together. So this is the way it looks like. As you can see, it's elastic. You are familiar with these because they are mostly used by a lot of people, the sportsmen, footballers, and the others. So now, in this first aid box, these elastic rolls of bandages we use in first aid when a patient has been bitten by a snake, either on the upper limb, the arm, or on the lower limb. We use this type of bandages to roll it, to apply it across all the entire limb so that we can slow down the movement of poison so it does not go faster to the heart and other parts of the body. So the 14th, this is a safety pin. These are safety pins. Simple as they may look, these are very important. They come in a quantity of 12. They are used to fasten bandages. Bandgel. They come in a quantity of 4 packets, as you can see. So there is a lotion inside of this packet. This is an ointment used to apply on wounds caused by burns as a pain reliever. That lotion which is found inside, you apply it on the wound. There will be a bit of some relief on that wound, and you do the treatment, and that's when you transport the patient to the hospital so that they do the rest of the medical treatment on that wound. This is a cervical collar. It's an instrument used to immobilize the spine on the back of the neck. So if a patient has been found in an accident, more especially those that involve collision or a fall from a height, and it was an impact, before we can handle the patient, we have to make sure that the neck of the patient has been immobilized. It is not moving from one end to the other. We need to apply this cervical collar. This cervical collar comes in a quantity of 1. We have 1 in the first aid box. We can even have more than this, but this is the minimum that we have in the first aid box. CPR mouthpiece. They come in a quantity of 2. There's one end which faces the patient and the other one where the facilitator is supposed to be facing. So it is for single use only. So this side must be up. It is the one the facilitator uses to blow air. This side it must face the patient. So now, the CPR is an instrument used when administering artificial respiration from the mouth of the fasteder to the mouth of the patient. So this essence is to avoid mouth-to-mouth contact. And it has a one-way valve which does not allow air to flow back from the patient to the fasteder. So as we administer that air into that patient, that air will not come back to us as if it goes the valve inside, just there, but that's by the neck. As you can see, there's a valve. Number 18, the strip plaster. These are the strip plasters that you are seeing here. This is just one of them that I've removed, this one. So this is the way it looks like. This is one of them. So now, these strip plasters are used, or they are applied on small wounds. We normally see if a patient has got maybe a cut on the face, just very small cut, we see them with the plasters on the face, on the arm, anywhere where there is a very small injury or where there is a very small wound, we can apply these strip plasters. So they come in a quantity of 30 swab. This is a packet of goose swab. So this is what is found inside. This is one of them, as you can see. So this is called goose swab. It comes in a quantity of one packet. So this is the material used to clean or wipe dirt around and away from the wound. And we use this. Well, this is normal saline. We only need the normal saline in the first aid box. So now this normal saline, this is the fluid used to wash the wound. It is made of salt and water. This is what we are going to be using in our episodes. We are going to be using normal saline. And so besides the 20 items that we discussed, the essential items which are found in the first aid box, there are some other instruments which you may need to have. The other important items are the AmbiBag. The AmbiBag is an instrument used to administer artificial respiration, like the CPR. But this one, it is easy to use in all cases, including a patient exposed to gases. It is not stressful as compared to other methods of artificial respiration. Then the other item that you need to have is a shock blanket. After an accident, most of the patients go into shock, and we need to treat it so that the patient does not deteriorate. The other instrument or the other item is a stretcher. You need at least one, a clinical stretcher or a stretcher that you may use to transport a patient. So this is the means in which a patient is transported safely and securely on a stretcher without having to move the patient unnecessarily. Now, with this first aid box and its contents and the other instruments, you can attend to almost all cases of injuries and probably help save a life as a first aider. It is therefore important to acquire a skill to know how to attend to the accident victims and help transport them to the hospital for further medical treatment. Well, this is what we had for you. Look out for more videos by pressing on that subscription button so that you get notifications, or like us by giving a thumbs up or a thumbs down. That depends on you. You can also leave a comment down there and I'll try to answer all the questions that will be posted. Thank you very much.